Hello, this is H.G. Bailey, and welcome back to Let's Play Final Fantasy IV! If you want to leave the dungeon, you can just step on that tile to the right there, but I don't want to for now, so let's move on. If you just want to skip the trial dungeon, you can. You can just walk right up here, go right around it, and you'll end up here. Ah, the Giant of Babil. If you need to stock up on sirens, this would be the place to do it. There is one new enemy that I'd like to meet up with around here. Could have met up with it before, but this time I'm gonna farm it. And there it is, the Lamia Queen. So yeah, there's a searcher, so if you want to use that, you can. Let's start with that. Let's see, Lamia Queen can be confused, so I could use Quorum's Cry ability. Why not? Someone was saying, H.G. Bailey, I don't know which one they were talking about, but they were saying, like, there was an enemy who you could... Back in the Giants of Babil, if you used thunder on them, they would, like, short-circuit or something and be confused for some reason. I don't know why. But that's what they said. So, I don't know. I would imagine that's true. Like, I don't think they would lie to me. You wouldn't lie to me, viewers. Right? Just to get me to say stuff? Nah, but, okay, we're done with this part. Where do we end up next? Ah, the Antlion's Den. Oh, well, there's the exit. That's easy. Let's go around here first. There's a treasure this time around that, well, wasn't there the first time we came into the cave. For the most part, when you go through these floors of remembrance that look like old floors you've been to before, the treasure chests will usually be in the same places as before, but not always. So, just take a look around. Yeah, now the floors are starting to get more straightforward and a lot shorter, thank goodness. Ah, the Chocobo's Forest, alright. Well, there was a floor that had some new enemies around here, but unfortunately I didn't see it, but oh well. But anyway, one thing that I wanted to mention about this place, because I was someone finally found some maps for me of all these floors in the Lunar Ruins, and I never realized this, but... This forest here, if you zoom out on a full map, you can... it looks like a chocobo. If you have to zoom out, like, there's the eye, there's its feathers here, and these woods here, so... Yeah, I never noticed that before. I never really looked at a map of the place, so... But anyway, if you saw up there, we got the Hog Call weapon, which is a sword... Not quite as good, but if you have Kane in your party, that's really good for him. It can turn enemies into a pig, so there you go. I think in the Game Boy Advance version, it was called the Piggy Stick? I forget. But, well, whatever. Okay. How do we get out of here? Oh, yeah, we can just restore all our MP, too. So it's just like a real forest. No black chocobos here, though. Afraid not. I thought that was how we would get out of here. Maybe it's over here? Yes, there we go. So yeah, make sure you pick up that Hog Call weapon, because that's really good for him. Gee, I wonder whose trial this could possibly be. Well, let's save first, just to be on the safe side. You never know, I might screw up this trial dungeon. But anyway, in order to enter this one, you have to have defeated Zeromus with Edward in your party. Whoa. What happened here? What's going on? This is the desert. Did hell freeze over? Apparently so. We are in hell. Oh, hey, it's a nice little harp there. The Requiem harp is... Well, I'll just tell you, it's not really a spoiler, but it's a temporary weapon for... Whoa. For Edward there. You don't need to equip it though. And this is playing out automatically. So I'm just gonna fast forward for a little while. It's pretty much scripted. So get him, Cecil. Nuts. Well, they're not attacking us or doing anything. What do we do now? He said wait. Okay, I guess we're not gonna wait. Huh? I'll swallow your soul! Okay, well, basically what we need to do here is we need to find all of those soul enemy things, whatever, and release them. I guess they're all really cold or something. I don't know. Okay, so what you gotta do here is you don't need the Requiem's harp equipped. Just kill them once, then use Bard Song on them, and that should do the trick. There we go. Yeah, remember Requiem from Final Fantasy V? Yeah, that was pretty good. But not so much in this game, so now I'm gonna take care of the rest of these guys. Okay, there's only one more off screen. Okay, that's all the ones on this floor. Let's see, only one here, I guess. And let's see, we got one, two. Does this work? Hey, all right. Healing point right in the middle of the trial dungeon. Let's see, does that work? No. Okay, well, we got two of these guys to clear out, so I'll take care of them off screen then. Okay, took care of all those guys, so... Nothing happened. Oh, there we go. I was gonna say nothing happened, but now this guy's here. Let's take him out. And... Ah, there we go. I was gonna say, wait, what? Nah, I knew something was gonna happen. Is there a draft? Well, where is it? It's a secret passage! Down here. Well, let's take a look around. This part is very mazy. So, actually, I don't think there are any enemies around here, so I'm just gonna run free, I guess. Ah, there's the first one. So, are these supposed to be, like, the ghosts of the people who were killed by Golbez in the raid on Damsan? Maybe Edward's still traumatized by it after going through a secret passage! I always thought these trial dungeons... Oh, you could go through there if you want, but I don't. I always thought these trial dungeons were supposed to, I don't know, elaborate more on the characters a little bit. I don't know, I mean, I guess I wasn't expecting, like, Chrono Trigger side quests, where they really develop the characters a lot more with them, but, well, you'll see. I'll talk a little more about it when I get to the end. Okay, well, I think that's all of them. I don't know what happens if you don't kill all of them. I forget. Well, that's that. This is the exit. I don't think you need to kill them to get to the exit. Guess who's at the end of this place, viewers? Okay, so let's see. We got a palace harp. You might want the protect ring. Well, someone wants it. No, actually, yeah, let's leave Yang alone. Yeah, Yang, you're screwed. Sorry. Okay, yeah, we're all set and ready to go. Who's there? Not that we ever needed it. So I don't know why they gave it to us. The brave do not fear the grave. For boss time! This is Lunar Shiva, and she is not a pushover. Well, most of them aren't, but first things first, let's use Spider Silk on her. Got the Flame Claws on Yang there. Oh yeah, every time you do something like that, she'll heal herself like that, so do that first. Let's use our new deadly command. Yeah. And let's put you on a Bacchus Wine now. And have Rydia use Garaga. Maybe have Palum help out. Porum. Sorry, they just look so similar. Maybe get haste. Well, yeah, get haste on Rydia. Well, maybe I should have had her haste herself. I'm not going to have Cecil attack. I'm going to keep him on standby. Because otherwise she will kill you. Fortunately, we have many ways of dealing max damage to her. Unfortunately, magic does kind of cause her to do that. So, it's still worth it, obviously. But, you know, try to avoid other magic besides that. Wow, look at that damage! Go Edward. It's a good thing the Apollo's Harp is fire elemental. Why we're using it. Oh, this is gonna hurt. Goodbye, Yang. Oh, that wasn't so bad. Yeah, because I had the protect rings or other various protection against ice. So yeah, that's why I got the Crystal Helm, the Robe of Lords, the protect rings. Unfortunately, I don't have a third one for Yang, but he has so much HP, it doesn't really matter, and Deadly's better anyway. So, yeah, you don't piss off Edward. He's going Berserko. Bizarro? No. Bizarro, Edward. Holy cow, that would be scary. Go ahead, put yourself on ice. See if I care. All of these Lunar Eidolons that we're fighting have some sort of massive attack that they charge up for, and you can totally see it coming. So, well, so far I haven't had to really use Cecil on standby. So far, so good. Alright. Maybe she's not nearly as hard as I was making her out to be. I remember these... Oh, this is gonna hurt. Huh. I remember these being a lot harder than that. Might as well use Kiraja. And this battle is not gonna last that long. Yeah! Got her! Wow, that was enormously easier than I thought it would be. But anyway, part of the reason why I used Edward and Yang, well, both for the first two trial dungeons, but to be honest, Edward is really not that good at this point. The only reason he was really good in the first place was because of all those dragons in the final dungeon. Here, not so much, so we're gonna get rid of him soon. And for defeating her, well, we got the Lunar Shiva book. What else do we get for our efforts? We get the Harmony Ring. All right. Let's see what that does. I forget what that does. I don't think I ever use it. Oh, he said rest in peace. So, how sweet. I guess it does something to your command. Well, let's find out. Oh, it changes it to chant. A shanty? No. But, yeah, you could use that if you want, but I'd rather keep him on the protect ring, but, well, I might as well give it to him, because I'm going to get rid of him now. Basically, what I want to do is I'm going to leave the Lunar Ruins this way, and then I'm going to have to work my way all the way back down here with a different party, so that way I can take on all the remaining trials here. Next time on Let's Play Final Fantasy IV! This is H.C. Bailey, signing off. Have a good day! See, even he's waving goodbye.